point unto the multitude of acts of mercy. Blot out my transgressions, wash me thoroughly from my iniquities, and cleanse me from my sins. For I acknowledge my transgressions, and my sin is ever before me. Against thee only have I sinned and done this evil in thy sight, that thou mightest be justified when thou speakest, and be clear when thou judgest. Behold, I was shapen in iniquity, and in sin my mother conceived me. Thou desirest, behold, thou desirest truth in the inward parts, and in the hidden parts thou shalt make me to know wisdom. Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Make me to hear joy and gladness, that the bones which thou hast broken may rejoice. Hide thy face far from my sins, and blot out all my iniquities. Create me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me.
Yes.
Restore to me the joy of thy salvation, and uphold me with thy free spirit. Then will I teach transgressors thy ways, and sinners shall be converted unto thee. Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God, thou God of my salvation, and my tongue shall sing aloud of thy righteousness. O Lord, open thou my lips, and my mouth shall show forth thy praise. For thou desirest not sacrifices, else would I give it. Thou desirest delight not in burnt offerings. Sacrifices of God are a broken spirit, and a broken and a contrite heart, O God, thou wilt not despise. Psalms 139. Verses 23 and 24. Search me, O God, and know my heart. Try me and know my thoughts, and see if there be any wicked way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting. Our theme is let heaven know. You have good intentions. Our main verses for this text are taken from Psalms 51, verses 1 through 5. Verses 1 through 4. In this time in which we live, it seems that everyone has planned or plots to get to or reach something or someone. Sometimes some strive to make it big in life. But the way some have had to go in order to reach the destination is not always a straight or an upright route. Y'all work with a brother. Sometimes we have had to do things for life's survival that we would carry to our grave. Yeah. Although our plan was outlined, what it took or even takes is not always written in the scheme of things. Now, suggest this is why you never look down on anyone. You never put up your nose at anyone. You never say what you will or will not do, what will or won't happen. You never say you can't stand someone else because of what they have done in life.
Right.
I wish I could get one or two good amens.
Amen.
Because life will lead, life will let you sing, but sometimes life changes the words to your song.
Right.
It changes the beat and the amount of time you sing the chorus. God planned and proving ground for our lives sometimes will throw us in deep water and teach us how to swim, or land us in the ice, rain, and snow of life to teach us how to drive in bad weather. But may I encourage you that even in these times, God is with us.
Right.
According to Deuteronomy 31 and 6 and Hebrew 13 and 5, not only is he with us, but Isaiah 41 and 10 says, and Psalms 63 and 81 tell us that our God will also uphold us with his right hand. Yeah. Subject again, let heaven know you have good intentions.
Right.
The word intention means the thing you plan to do or achieve, or an aim or a purpose or a goal. Well, our text deals with David. David, the chosen of God. David, the 8-year-old anointed king. David, the herdsman. David, the protector of the sheep. David, the fighter. David, the master musician. David, the sexy one, whose scripture says was of a fair countenance and a goodly to look upon. David, the murderer. David, the whoremonger. David, the praise dancer and the dancing praiser. This David, a man after God's own heart.
All right, Apostle.
This same David, like many of us, love God and want to please him. But just like many of us, found himself in a place.
God knows.
Praise God, Apostle.
Where is a place? Lord, help me. You ask the place you are in after you rolled around with the pigs in the pig's pen. That's a place.
Yeah.
The place you are when you come down off your high and the drugs wear off. That's a place. The place you are with the headache and the hangover after you've enjoyed the season of sin.
Yeah.
The place, praise God, you are after sex and cigarette.
My Lord.
And after you can never repeat and repent enough, and the sex wasn't even worth it.
My God.
The place you are after you can't find the peace of mind in yourself to forgive yourself. That place is called a place. Well, David found himself at this place. And lays aside who he is. Lays aside what he is. Lays aside how anointed he is. Lays aside how spiritual he is. Lays aside how skillful he is. And says to God, have mercy on me, O God. Blot out my transgressions. Wash me thoroughly or completely from my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sins. Is anybody with me? Let heaven know you have good intentions. three things in this acknowledgement. First thing he said is, I acknowledge my transgressions. I want to say to you today, you need to tell and acknowledge the truth about you and your mess.
Right.
The second thing he said was, my sin is ever before me.
Yes.
Number two, don't act like you're sinless. Yes. When your sin is ever before your own eyes.
Yes.
Number three, he said, against thee and thee only have I sinned.
Yes.
Third point is, let God know it is not just that you did what you did, but that it is against his holiness.
Uh-huh.
The holiness of God.
Yes.
The righteousness of God.
Yes.
It is against God, the lover of your soul.
Yes.
In thought, word, or deed, according to St. Mark 7, chapter 7 and verse 23, and according to 1 John 2 and 1.
Yes.
David prays for mercy, humbly confessing and lamenting for his sin. He pleads for pardon. Why pardon? Because sometimes you're forgiven, but yet can't have your place back or your anointing back.
Right.
Because you're going to go through the right steps.
Right.
But David prays, Lord, I want everything back.
Yes.
God, help me. And even make right. Because my intentions are to promote your glory.
Yes.
And to convert sinners. Well, as I prepare to close, I want somebody in this room to know you need to change your motives and your mindset.
Right.
Just as David did.
Yeah.
You can't have heavenly intentions with hellish behavior.
All right.
Water and oil just don't mix. James 1 and 8 declares, a double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. So Joshua 24 and 15 says, choose ye this day
whom ye serve.
Shall serve. And then he said, and as for me, for some people, I need also to add, not only who you're going to serve,
yes,
but some need to choose what you're going to serve. For in St. John chapter 4, Jesus told them, ye worship, ye know not what.
Yes.
But we know who we worship.
Yes.
And we worship the Father because he's looking for somebody to worship him in spirit and in truth.
Yes.
But church, I can't say of all a truth. As for me and my house,
yes,
we will serve the Lord.
Yes.
I gotta let heaven know I have good intentions.
Yes.
I can't do it to please or satisfy anyone else.
Yes.
Cause a change to a charge to keep I have.
Yes. And a God to glorify. Yes.
And as the definition says, I want to hear joy and gladness. I want the right spirit in me. I want a clean heart. God, help me preach. I want to stay in God's presence. I don't want his Holy Spirit to depart. I need the joy of his salvation. I need...
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I need. I wrote, I need me.
Yes.
His free spirit.
Yes.
I got plans to teach transgressors his ways. And finally, I want to let heaven know,
yes,
I have good intentions.
Hallelujah.
By my praise.
Yes.
Why? By praise. Because Psalms 33 and 1 says, praise is comely, or may I say natural, first mindset for the upright. Then Psalms 138 and 1 says, I will praise you with my whole heart. Yes, Lord God. Psalms 9 and 1 says, praise the Lord with my whole heart. Psalms 86 and 12 says, I will praise you, Lord my God, and I'm gonna obey. Psalms 46, verse 1 and verse 10. Verse 1 says, praise ye the Lord. Verse 10 says, praise ye the Lord. Psalm 47, verse 1 says, praise ye the Lord. And then verse 20 says, praise ye the Lord. Psalm 148, verse 1 says, praise ye the Lord. And then verse 14 says, praise ye the Lord. Let heaven know you have good intentions by doing what Psalm 49 says. 149 and verse 1 says, praise ye the Lord. And then verse 9 says, praise ye the Lord. Psalms 150 says, praise ye the Lord. Let heaven know you have good intentions by lifting up your hands, by opening up your mouth, repenting of your sins, telling God, I know I messed up. I know I fell short. I know I didn't deserve your goodness. I didn't deserve your kindness. But because of your grace, because of your mercy, I'm not consumed. And I want to bless your name. Just like David said, in spite of myself, I know I'm a mess. I know I'm messed up. But bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Oh, my soul. And all that is within me. Fear nobody, because the Lord is with me. The Lord will undergird me. The Lord will fight for me. Can the church say yes? Can the church say yes? I realize we've been through the storm. We've been through the rain. But somebody has a testimony.